Volda, in the Vestlandet region of Norway, is where Sunnmøre Kransservice AS is based. In this part of the world, where the winters are cold, the fjords seemingly endless, and the islands countless, the crane hire company operates our LTM 1110-5.2 as a cold weather machine in field tests. Welcome to the second edition of our UpLoad video magazine in 2024. In the last issue, we presented our new edition, the LTR 1150. Today, we'll take a look at how one of the first 10 LTM 1110-5.2s is performing out in the field. But let's start with the topic of load-bearing capacity and statics. The next summer is on its way, and the associated temperature differences can also have an impact on crane use. We want to get to the bottom of the lateral boom curvature caused by temperature fluctuations. I'm joined by Joachim Henkel, head of our structural engineering department. Hi, Joachim.
Hi, Martin.
Joachim, load-bearing capacity is a very complex topic. Maybe you can summarize it for us.
Sure, no problem. In mobile crane construction, achieving the highest possible ratio of load capacity to dead weight is essential. For this reason, we use high-strength, weldable, fine-grained structural steels in our machines, which are up to 3 times stronger than conventional structural steels. But there are 2 sides to every coin. Due to these higher strengths, the deformation of the crane boom also increases, both in the direction of the radius and laterally. Lateral deformation in particular can cause uncertainty for the crane operator.
For some years now, we've seen a trend toward ever longer telescopic booms. And with these longer booms, another issue comes into play, namely the additional lateral deformation when the side of the boom heats up due to solar radiation.
Especially on cold, sunny winter days, this one-sided heating by the sun can be a challenge. It leads to a significant increase in the lateral boom curvature. With a temperature difference of 20 degrees Celsius between the left and right side, this lateral deformation can be considerable. In the case of our LTM 1230-5.1 crane, with a telescopic boom extended to 75 meters in a steep position, this one-sided deformation can be up to 2.8 meters.
Whereas 25 years ago, a 60-meter boom was sufficient for telescopic cranes in the 300-ton lifting capacity class, today, boom lengths of 80 or 90 meters are sometimes required for six-axle mobile cranes.
The longer the boom, the greater the lateral deformation. Incidentally, our own measurements show that a temperature difference of 20 degrees is an extreme value. Within this range, the crane can be operated safely in accordance with the load chart. However, the crane operator can minimize this lateral deformation by turning the superstructure or switching to a higher hoist rope reeving.
So to summarize, the additional lateral boom curvature caused by temperature differences is certainly a challenge, but the right measures can ensure that our cranes can be operated safely and reliably.
Yes, absolutely right.
Thank you, Joachim. With high-tech machines, extreme temperatures can affect more than just the crane boom. In the case of our new LTM 1110-5.2 mobile crane, we've therefore sent 10 pre-series machines to undergo field testing for the first time, during which they'll be monitored by our testing department using telemetry. One of these cranes is located in Sicily, where it operates in summer at temperatures of over 40 degrees Celsius. Its counterpart has been rolling onto construction sites in Norway since November. We watched our cold weather machine at work as winter set in, both on site and from aim.
Yeah. A few years ago, we got a sneak preview of the new Likon 3 crane with a new design that included both the operator's and driver's cab, as well as the rest of the crane. Even then, we decided that we should have one of the first Likon 3 cranes to be supplied by Liebherr. This crane can be transported on our roads without having to dismantle the boom, which is very helpful in our area due to the many bridges and the axle load restrictions. It's easier to reach customers with this crane than with other, heavier machines. It took a few years, but it's finally here. The crane is very nice, attractive design, nice colors in blue, and with Sunmura Crown Service RS logos on it, so I'm very happy with the purchase.
Everything in the driver's cabin, the chassis is new, and it's even better than before. It's almost like being inside a lorry in these modern cranes. There's a completely different display in the superstructure cab and a completely different support for your hands when driving the crane. It's just entirely different. It's definitely a good improvement.
We were lucky enough to get one of the first 10 Likon 3 cranes in the world delivered to Norway. This crane will undergo cold weather testing and will be exposed to temperatures as low as minus 40 degrees Celsius to prove that it can function without any problems. I'm convinced that it will succeed. The machine is connected to the Liebherr plant in Ingen via modems, so the crane driver can activate the modem in the event of difficulties, and the plant can read out the errors and find solutions.
We use telemetry to monitor the 10 field test machines from our development department on a daily basis so we can act quickly if the worst comes to the worst. Basically, a field test like this is nothing new for us. We've already done this in the past with individual components. What's different this time is that we are testing the complete vehicle with all the subcomponents. The data logger sends us error messages and the associated boundary parameters. The architecture is then set up in such a way that we can quickly analyze these error messages and the boundary parameters. This in turn helps us to avoid serial damage and then sustainably increase product quality. So you could say that the field test is the dress rehearsal before series production. We've actually been testing a normal prototype like this for about a year. Our current test with the LTM 1110-5.2 was a little bit different, because we are using the Likon 3 crane control system here for the first time. We've had 3 whole years to optimize and test the machine. There's nothing quite like working outside on the customer's construction site, and that's where the field test helps us enormously, of course.
I would say that there's a big difference compared to the old system. It's more user-friendly for the crane operator, more transparent, and it is many years ahead of what was supplied in the past.
Did you know that Norway is focusing very strongly on the green transition? And that in Oslo, for example, only zero-emission vehicles will be allowed in parts of the city center from 2025. Of course, this also affects property developers, as government contractors demand emission-free machines. Regulation 2016-1628 came into force in the EU on January 1, 2019. This regulation applies to all diesel engines installed in our cranes. And since then, we've been delivering our cranes with Stage 5 engines to all EU countries and a few other countries. what has changed since then and what needs to be considered when replacing a diesel particle filter? Norbert Maier, head of technical customer service, is here to tell us. Hello, Norbert.
Hi, Martin. Since the regulation came into force, we've been supplying our machines with crane engines that meet the Stage 5 exhaust emission requirements. These engines are based on the familiar SCR system, but also include a closed particulate filter system. This system filters almost all particles out of the exhaust gas. Ultimately, this also serves to protect the environment.
It's really good that this technology is now being implemented. How often is it necessary to change the diesel particle filter on our cranes?
Actually, it isn't necessary very often at all. A replacement is necessary after around 5,000 operating hours or more. The leak on display unit indicates this to the driver.
And how exactly is this change carried out?
The change itself requires precise execution. In addition to the actual hardware replacement, this change must also be displayed in the crane and engine control unit. The load status is then reset to zero. This also serves to protect the components, otherwise they could be destroyed.
That sounds like a pretty challenging task. How does Liebherr help customers to make the switch successfully?
To this end, we have designed a special workflow in My Liebherr that guides the customer step by step through the changeover. This is set up for all cranes with Likon 2 and higher and exhaust emission stage 5.
Does this mean that customers will always have to make the switch by themselves in future?
No, not at all. We've created another free digital service for our customers to use. This saves them money and gives them more flexibility. Of course, our customer service team and our service partners around the world are still happy to carry out filter changes for our customers.
Great, thank you very much, Norbert, for these insights. And that brings us to the end of the second edition of our UpLoad magazine this year. I'm particularly looking forward to the next issue, because that's when we'll be showing ourselves in the best possible light, during our customer days here in Ehingen, with lots of news and new LTM cranes, of course. So, bye for now, and see you then!